Hello everyone, students, it's day 11 and today we are going to discuss very important topic from this chapter, and that is sexual reproduction in humans. Sexual reproduction, you know, is the process of giving birth to young ones by the fusion of the gametes, which are produced by both the sexes, right? Male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ they have got, which produce male gametes and female gametes, and during fertilization they fuse together and produce zygote, then result in embryo and baby is born. But do you think that these reproductive organs, they are active from the birth itself? So let's try to understand. First, the baby is born, right? When the babies are born, they are very small and it's difficult to identify the male and the female because they almost look similar. Then their growth starts, like their weight increases, their height starts increasing, right? Slowly and slowly they reach at a stage where different type of changes they start taking place in the body, and this is known as the age of puberty. In boys it is 13 to 14 years, and in girls the puberty age is 10 to 12 years, but this can also vary. We can say the age at which the hormones they begin to be produced, and the boys and girls they become sexually mature, is known as the age of puberty. Here we can see the changes in males at puberty, like facial hair growth takes place, widening of shoulders, deepening of voice, and growth of sex organs. In females, widening of hips and pelvis, pitch of the voice that becomes high, initiation of the menstrual cycle that takes place, and also the mammary glands, they start increasing in size. Some of the changes, they are common in both the males as well as the females, like growing of thick hair in armpits, genitalia, and on the legs and face also, the hair they start appearing, and also skin that becomes oily, and there is development of pimples, right? Now let's discuss male and female reproductive system separately. Male reproductive system, that consists of a pair of scrotum, then a pair of testes, epididymis, or we can say epididymis, which leads to into vas deferens, and then ejaculatory duct, and then that goes into the penis, right? Now what happens is the sperms, they are produced by the testes, then they get stored into the epididymis. Through the vas deferens they go into the ejaculatory duct, where they meet the urethra from the urinary bladder, and also secretions of the glands, that is Cowper's glands, prostate gland, and seminal vesicles is also poured into the sperms, and then they get ejaculated through the penis into the body of the female, or we can say into the vagina of the female. Next is, what is the function of reproductive system, male reproductive system? In fact, function is to produce sperms, second is to produce testosterone hormone, and also to transfer the sperms to the female reproductive system, right? So one important question which is generally asked, that why the scrotum is placed below the or outside the abdominal cavity. The reason is that sperm formation that requires lower temperature than the body, normal body temperature. So in the scrotum the temperature is 3 degrees lower than the normal body temperature. Always remember, right? Next is female reproductive system, which consists of a pair of ovaries, a pair of fallopian tubes, which is also known as oviducts, and then uterus, which is a bag, and then muscular bag, we can say. Next is vagina, right? So what is the function of female reproductive system is that is to produce ova, which are produced by ovaries, right? Next is to produce female sex hormones, that is estrogens and progesterone. Also remember that ovas, they are produced by ovaries through the fallopian tubes, where the fertilization takes place. They fuse with the sperms, which we'll discuss in the next class. And then this is the uterus, which is a muscular bag where the zygote is formed. And then cervix is the terminal portion of the uterus, we can say, and then it moves into the vagina. So this was about the female reproductive system. Now here is slide for your homework. You have to do all these questions. First try to understand the this reproductive system. Clear, students? Thank you. See you in the next class.